We got this tool here, which is just a weed puller, or to till up the flower bed. You just take it and stab it in the ground and twist, and it loosens the ground or pops weeds out. And I think we're gonna take this and make it into something. So I'm looking at, I see a stand right here. I have no idea what in the hell this was. Believe it might have been like a water meter reach down valve or something, but it's been sitting in the scrap pile too long. So I got to looking at this, and then this could interlock into here, and that could make us a little stand. Let me see if that, yep, that's in the frame. All right, so I think we got the beginnings of something here. Let's do a little chopping and cutting, see what we come up with. All right, so what I'm looking at here is we have this piece, which of course we need to get all these death nails off of it, but this little piece will hook right here and then make us a stand. And I don't want to have two pieces, because if I do that, we're always going to be looking for the second piece. So I found a couple of eyes. I think if we cut them here and weld them, one on each side, that'll give us this kicker, and it'll permanently stay attached, and we don't have to worry about losing a piece. So we're going to clean this up and see if we can't get our pieces attached. All right, so we got to get rid of some of this, some of these death nails here. Let me make sure I got the vise in the frame. All right. So I got these marked. We're going to cut these two. These two, we're going to straighten them, and that'll be a carrying handle. These two got to go for personal injury reasons. So what I'm thinking is we're going to put this in the vise before we do anything and see if we got enough to straighten them out. All right. Put this one in there. Oh, let me get it all the way down. I hope the wind isn't bothering y'all. Got some weather changing. All right, so we'll bend that. Alright, so now these two are straight, so I'm going to cut these off, take a piece of this and make a handle, and cut the rest of this off. So let me get to my marks where I can see them. Alrighty, let's put this in the vise, see if we can cut this up a little bit. Alright guys, well here's our finished product, making treasure out of trash. We got our garden tool flipped upside down. We used the cleats or the spikes to make a handle. And we got an extra old T-handle off of something. We robbed all of that out of the scrap iron. We got enough room to hold several rolls of wire with just some 3/4 inch nuts on the outside. That was some old all thread that we had, so this didn't cost anything but a little welding wire and some time. And hey, that's practicing welding every time you get a chance. So this is going to come in handy on our trailer project because we've got to pull wires on it, which we'll be getting to shortly, and finishing up the trailer. As you can see, we got our new deck boards kind of spotted in place, but we've got a few more welding items to do on that. We'll get to that on the next video. But anyhow, this is how you make a wire rack or a wire dispenser off of a bunch of junk in the junk pile. And like I said, get some practice welding while you're at it. So when you're done with it, catch the T-handle, pick it up. The T-handle folds up. You can hang it and use it to pull wire off at the shop if you need it. And then when you're ready to do something like the trailer project, put the T-handle out. And she's ready to go. So trash from treasure or treasure from trash, and we got a good tool we can use for a long time. All right guys, thanks for watching. We'll see y'all on the next one shortly, and hope you enjoy.